Morning, Tom.
George.
Ah, saved. It's the cavalry at last. You're early this morning, Stu. Been relief, been in trouble with timekeeping.
We know we're seeing you lot.
I might not turn up at all tonight. After last night, I could do with a week at home.
Right. For your delectation, Mr. Colliandros in one. Serious assault. Priority job when CID eventually waltz in. This chap in three, Collins, dealing, we reckon. Caught in possession, piles of ready cash, deeply offensive manner. Two and four had drunks in them, but I managed to clear them all out for you with a proverbial boot up the backside. So, that's your lot. I'm off to slip into a well-earned coma. May the force be with you.
Cheers, Sarge. Find one of the sergeants.
Did he call an ambulance?
He's well dead, Sarge. Looks like he's been hit over the head, too.
Call one anyway. Did you see him come in here?
No, Sarge. Can't be recent, though. He's cold.
Did he move the body?
No, Sarge.
Good, okay. Get the CAD room to call in the divisional surgeon, and you better get CID out of it as well.
Right, Sarge.
Why did you want me? I was meant to be getting the kids to school this morning.
You might need your discreet touch.
In here. The Socko's on her way round. So's Mr. Brownlow.
I see what you mean. Who was in custody?
Tom Penny.
I'm sure there's a perfectly simple explanation.
Yeah, well, that's your job, isn't it?
Sergeant?
Morning, sir.
CID, huh?
Yes, sir. They're checking the cell where the man was last night.
Right.
Right, sir. Uniforms to forensic and the officers to be placed in separate rooms.
No one's to talk to them. Not a word about McPhee. When they get here, let me know. I'll be Martha's, right?
Better be a very good reason for all this.
Yeah, Sarge, what's going on?
I can't say. I'm sorry. Let's just get it over with, shall we? Morning, Rich.
Where are they?
Oh, I see. It's Reg Hollis, Federation representative, is it?
Oh, come on, Sarge, don't mess me about. I've got to talk to them.
You should know better. It's up to Mr. Brownlow and MS-15 whether you can talk to them or not.
Look, whose side are you on?
It's not a matter of sides. I'm on their orders.
All right, if that's the way you want it, I'm getting a Federation solicitor in.
You do what you want. Well, the early turn's blown in. You done something in the bed, old sonny?
Quiet night?
Oh, so sorry, you know. Smelling a bit glamorous this morning, aren't we? Expecting an examiner.
Is this right?
What?
Three calls to the Overton Arms.
Oh, four if you count the junk locked up outside.
This McMullen needs sorting out.
Oh, Terry? He's as good as gold. Listen, before you go brown nosing to the bosses, this has been waiting in the fridge since Monday night.
This arrest of yours was at 11:45.
So what?
He's obviously been drinking after hours.
Have a nice day.
Sign there. You've been released on bail. You'll be required to attend the court on the date shown on the form. If you fail to attend, you will be arrested. Do you understand?
Yes. What's happened to Dashwood, do you know?
I'm not paid to sit here and chat with you. Get out of here. Go on, shift.
Now, what about the inspector? Is he still around? Mr. Munro?
Nope. He's gone home. If you've got anything to say, you can say it to me.
No, look, I want to see one of the other inspectors. Well, come on, it's important.
A wallet containing bank and credit cards and £15. Small change totaling £2.84. A box of cheroots.
Come on in. This way.
A gold lighter inscribed Derek. As you've admitted to a previous criminal record, you'll doubtless be familiar with police procedure, Mr. Robillard.
I haven't been arrested for over 5 years, so the experience is hardly engraven on my mind.
Then allow me to refresh your memory. Under the terms of your arrest, you have the right to inform someone of your arrest. You have the right to consult with a solicitor.
There's no one I wish to inform of my arrest, nor do I need a solicitor.
We're holding on to the gold lighter, Mr. Robillard. We've found its owner. He lives down in Kent.
I'm delighted to hear it. I'm sure I'd be very glad to get it back.
Well, would you like us to take it home, sir?
No, thank you. I'd rather walk. I need some air after being in a police station again.
See what else you might pick up.
You never know.
We've designated the female cells as a high security area. Armed officers are on watch here and at access points to the station.
Right, good. Custody records?
Sir.
Lots of action last night.
Both prisoners have complained about the circumstances of their arrest and they've repeatedly asked for access to a solicitor and for people outside to be told they're in custody.
They've been informed of the reasons for refusal, haven't they?
Sir, they understand it's on your instructions.
Good. I know it's a burden. All we can do is play it according to the rules and, God willing, we'll be fireproof.
Yes, sir. That's Harris they're bringing back. They'll be wanting the woman again now. Excuse me, sir.
All right.
Well, you can swear it, man, can't you? I've got to get home.
Never mind about getting home. Harrison said it came up for review at 36 hours and nothing happened. That was 2 hours ago. Nobody noticed or what?
Yeah, well, they were being interviewed at the time and Mr. Gray said it can be interrupted. It'd give reasons for continued detention at the first opportunity.
Yeah, then what?
Well, they're still interviewing Harris. There hasn't been an opportunity.
And your governor stood for that?
And whose side is this supposed to be on?
Yeah, and who's going to be on our side if this all goes pear-shaped?
You ready to check the prisoners now?
Oh, yeah, I'm just going to make a phone call, all right.
Well, can we do this first? It is 10-2, you know.
All right.
This first one, there was a warrant out for a non-appearance at court. He came in and gave himself up a couple of hours ago. No prizes for guessing where he'd been.
It smells like a public toilet.
He'll be no bother. This one, name of Mackenzie. A prey, D&D, assault on police, grievous bodily harm. Not a nice fella on balance.
What about some grub?
Button your lip right. Just button it. Turned out to be quite an event for our lot. You know that offer on Bridge Street?
Oh, yeah, I passed it on the way in. Broken window.
Yeah, that's right. The old circus got called out. The bloke he was fighting, he's in accident and emergency in St. Hugh's. Severed the main artery in his arm.
Nasty.
Yeah, he's got Ted Ruggs sitting by his bed waiting for a statement. Oh, come on, Charlie, boy. Back on the floor. I tell you, you're going to be up and down all night with this one.
I want some grub!
I'll stick him on the floor. He's fast asleep. Now, 15 minutes later, he's back up there again. I don't know, he does it.
Just the three, then?
Yeah. Well, of course, if CID get a result with this raid of theirs, it might get busier.
What raid?
There's a stakeout. Drugs or something. Frankly, if it goes down after the end of my shift, I don't want to know.
Bullets from Italy! Landmark raid.
There you go, mate.
Cheers.
We've finished all the property, Sarge.
Right. Right, I'm off then. Clint Eastwood on the box tonight.
Oh.
See you tomorrow?
Well, no, I've got leave owing.
Ah, nice one. Oh, ta-ta, then.
Ta-ta, Sarge.
They started it! He went for me,
I didn't do anything!
In the car. They started it! I didn't do anything!
Argument in the pub, Sarge. You smacked June Ackland.
Filth!
Afraid so.
I love you!
Calm
Let me
down.
Have him on
you! Calm down! And shut up!
Filth!
Bin him!
I love you!
You'll be seen when you've calmed down!
Sorry, Sarge.
That's your idea of a quiet drink, is it?
No, it's been a quiet shift, really. Just a couple of bodies in for the night.
Bob, don't go away, Dave. I want a word with you before you book off.
Yes, sir.
Don't worry, Dave. You can count on us.
I've got to apologise for this one, Stuart. I'd intended to get off my hands before you arrived.
Luck of the draw, isn't it? You're going to be a nuisance.
Well, it hasn't exactly been a picnic. Juvenile court in the morning. All right, Colin? All right.
Yeah.
Anything you need, lad? Do you want to wash and brush up? Maybe an extra blanket? Yeah? What's up, lad?
Sorry.
All right, mate.
I didn't mean it. Tell my dad.
Now, come on. You just sit tight here. You won't come home any harm. Okay?
Thanks.
Not wishing to be a harbinger of doom, but you sure you're up to speed?
To what?
This interview. In fact, you want to be yak sergeant because there's a 9-to-5 ESSA. Job may not be music to their ears.
Well, I'm not going to tell them that, am I? I'm going to tell them I want to broaden the horizons.
It's a bit vague, isn't it?
I've got a lot to offer.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
I've got rapport with teenagers, for a start.
Poor? You only see your own kids once a month.
I can handle it. And the interview. Local man, local knowledge. Monroe and Conway on the board. Bye-bye, shift work.
You do appreciate, Sergeant Lamont, the difference in subtlety between a youth and community office and a charge room?
Oh, well, naturally, sir. It's because I want to explore that subtlety that I'm applying for the job.
OK, then, a little scenario for you. A lad of 15, call him Kevin, lives with his mum. She's divorced. One night, Kevin, who's never been in trouble before, gets a six-pack from the off-licence, gets drunk, and he's picked up by us about midnight, making a lot of noise in the high road, having smashed a car windscreen. The case is referred to you as Yak Sergeant. What do you do?
Well, first offence, I'd recommend a caution, providing that some amicable arrangement could be come to over the criminal damage, paying for the windscreen, like.
Yes. Anything else? You wouldn't talk to Kevin's mum?
Oh, well, obviously, yes. When she came in for his caution.
And what would you say to her?
I'd ask her to impress on him not to behave like a prat.
You wouldn't attempt to find out why he was suddenly behaving like a prat, as you put it?
How'd it go?
You know, I think I'm in with a shout.
Sarge!
Cleaners are still up there, sir. Nobody expected you back this early.
Exactly. So another quiet night, then?
Oh, we've got one that's carried over. Noise disturbance on the Cockroft. Cat's had a report that it started up again.
A party? All nighter?
Well, I don't know. It's been reported on and off throughout the shift. By the time the area car gets down there, it's quiet as a grave. No one at home.
Somewhere.
That's that.
Have you got that?
He's not taking any calls. We did leave a message for him in his answer phone.
Yeah? Well, why don't you try again, or are you too thick to remember the number? You've got no right, and you know that. You're holding me here against my will.
That's probably true enough. Anything else you'd like?
Yeah. How about some black coffee, you snotball? How long are you going to keep us banged up in here, eh? Where's my brief? You're trying to sweat me, ain't you? You haven't even phoned him yet, have you?
Of course we have. He's at a conference in Brighton. But he said the office would send somebody else. Now listen, do you want to come out here and have a little chat with us?
You must be nuts or something. I'm keeping stum until he gets here. If I spoke to you, I'd get fitted up with shooting Kennedy or something. Look, just go and phone him again now. And that's all I'm saying, you deadheads.
How much is the coffee, by the way?
Skunk!
Mr. Dwyer, Mr. Pitcock,
and Mr. Barrett, handling stolen goods.
Oh, yeah, I booked him in last night. I thought he'd be gone by now.
DC's case says he's been very cooperative.
One of Rod's dead certs, eh?
How you doing?
Good. Nice to start the day with a ray of sunshine.
Well, they're all yours, mate. I'm off.
Yeah, cheers. See you tomorrow.
All right.
I'm hungry.
So what?
Can you pop to a shop for me? I'll pay you back.
You won't have to. I'm not going anywhere.
Oh, but I'm really, really hungry.
You should have had the meal we offered you when you had the chance then.
Oh, that muck.
We eat it.
Well, you would, wouldn't you? It's pig swill.
What's wrong, Mickey? You want to go home, do you? Forget it. You're not going anywhere till I've had some answers.
Thanks, Stuart.
Hold on.
Yeah, I've verified a phone number with the prisoner, OK?
Right, Don, I'll make a note of that on the custody record.
Do you have to do that?
Well, it might slip my mind.
Good night.
June! Late turn already, is it?
Yeah, doesn't time fly when you're enjoying yourself?
I wouldn't know.
What problem?
Nothing you can't help me sort out, no.
Right, Stuart, tell me the worst.
Oh, hiya, June. No, you're okay at the moment. Only two males.
Drunk, crusty, suicidal?
No, nothing like that, I'm pleased to say. This is Mr. Rafferty, possession class B with intent to supply. Selling cannabis to eight-year-olds.
Oh, nice.
Did you want something?
No.
Oh, you couldn't leave that open, could you?
No, I couldn't.
His mother's been on the phone on the hour, every hour, insisting that we give her little boy something to eat.
What, is he due a meal?
I could have had one if he wasn't so fussy. Now, this is Mr. Harper, aggravated burglary.
Hmm.
Don Beach has taken against this bloke in a big way. That's getting quite personal now.
Right, I'll go through the details, then you can sign him over.
Well, I never bother shutting that one.
Don't you? I do.
So what was so strange?
The informant said that a male IC1 was sitting in a red Vauxhall Vectra, engine running, outside the post office in Siskin Street. Naturally, we sent a mobile unit along to take a look.
And?
The Vectra had gone by the time they arrived, but we did a PNC check on the index we were given. The registered keeper was shown as a Stephen Loxton from Sun Hill. Imagine our surprise.
Steve Loxton?
Is there a problem, sir?
I'm making sure there isn't one, Stuart. I don't want the area inspection team finding any mistakes you and I have missed.
When are they coming?
Half an hour. DVU and CAD room first, but I've already been up there. They'll be down here after changeover. But don't think that lets you off the hook, because if I find so much as a comma out of place, I will personally crucify every custody officer and jailer who's been on duty this week.
Seems a bit harsh, sir.
I want the inspection team to be impressed, Stuart. I'm responsible for custody. I get marked down if there are any problems.
It's only an area inspection. It's no big deal.
Wrong, Stuart. For me, it's a very big deal.
But why?
I have my reasons.
Right. Well, go polish the keyholes then.
Good.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what happened. I just flushed it and the water came pouring out.
Don't worry about it. We've had problems with that toilet before.
Hey, I don't suppose you could leave the hatch open. I'm a little claustrophobic.
I'm not supposed to. Sorry.
Please. You won't hear another peep out of me.
We're full now.
Well, what's wrong with number two?
The bog's blocked. I'll call the surveyor's department.
No chance of getting a plumber this year, I suppose. Was that asking too much?
I think it'll be sometime today.
Good.
Probably.
Michael Haslam.
Good as gold. But he is claustrophobic.
Really?
Hey, don't shut the hatch, please! Please!
Oh, yeah. So he is.